Some say the high school is hell. I've never given a thought about this till yesterday. It hit fast. I don't know how and why, but in the matter of an hour, everyone I knew was either craving for flesh or mercy. Those not infected were running like hell.
Freeze! Hold it right there!
Hold it!
Open fire! Fire!
No! Police didn't help. Neither did the National Guard. So, they locked the school, with us inside. Three survivors, Pom Pom Girl, Jock, and Jarhead. Soldier keeps claiming there's a guarded door we can escape through. All we need to do is reach it.
Thank you.
March 7th, 2015, 1 a.m. The patient with vast internal damage. Internal bleeding from punctured spleen and probably liver, too. Blood loss around 4 units. Type A+. The spleen was stitched up, but without blood, he will die by the dawn. Transfusion of type O negative. 2 units. Patient remains alive. March 8th, 2015, 4 p.m. I, Michael Evans, on March 7th, 2015, 11:40 a.m., have found an accident victim lying on the side of Route 95, 3 miles from Massville. I have taken the unconscious patient to the facility and diagnosed internal bleeding, broken ribs, and a punctured spleen. I had to operate, but due to a lack of type A blood, I couldn't keep his blood pressure stable. I've transfused my own type O negative blood, 2 units, and injected an experimental stasis stimulant containing suppressed viruses of hemorrhagic fevers. The patient has remained in a coma and been stable for the past 24 hours. All the described actions were performed directly by myself, without third parties. My assistant, Spike Rockwell, was informed about the fact on March 8, 2015, and advised me to inform the authorities.
I used to be a cop, too. 15 years in criminal homicide. Left because of booze. 18 months sober.
March 9th, 2015, 2 p.m. Rats 16 and 23, previously separated, remained quarantined in one single cage. Both males were recovering faster than expected.
Why?
March 12th, 2015, 1 a.m. At 9 p.m., patient has awakened and broken 4 stitches, but he immediately tranquilized and given morphine, MS Contin 120 by 12. Fever remains in spite of being given corticosteroids. March 14th, 2015, 3 a.m. Patient has had a lumbar puncture and blood taken to be analyzed. Elevated levels of the 1433 protein led to the conclusion that he also had spongiform encephalopathy. Anyway, this still makes no sense, as such symptoms appear too early to develop. Cerebrospinal fluid, meningitis, spongiform encephalopathy. Blood, rabies, and toxoplasmosis. Small puncture scars all over his body seem to look like bat bites, who spread the rabies. Toxoplasmosis spread due to immune deficiency. Rabies and toxoplasmosis are developed and already untreatable. The patient will die within a couple of weeks, maybe even days. Thank you.
my God.
March 17th, 2015, 11 p.m. Current research consentaneously led to the conclusion prion diseases have long or very long incubation period. It seems to be literally impossible to develop such advanced syndromes within a couple of days, maybe even hours. March 18th, 2015, 6 a.m. My patient is dead, but it wasn't his condition which killed him. He got away, jumped off the old control tower, and has been found by the police. He was strapped into the bed. He couldn't have untied himself. March 19th, 2015, 2 a.m. Rat 23's brain autopsy indicates some changes leading to many hormone production malfunctions, including adrenal insufficiency. This leads to cortisol, hormone of stress, and dopamine overproduction, sodium deficiency, and indirectly causing serotonin, hormone of happiness, underproduction. Such condition leads to increased aggression, craving for sodium-rich products like a raw meat or blood plasma, including brain inflammation symptoms, meningitis. This leads to a conclusion such an organism is not capable of conscious thinking. Until its primal needs are fulfilled, it's just brainless. March 20th, 2015, 1 a.m. Rat 23 found over the carcass of Rat 16, put down. Dissection observations, sudden loss of fur, enlarged genitals. Brain biopsy, transmissible spongiform encephalopathy detected. Pathogen agent, prions, origins unknown. Assuming prions are actually real, the laboratory rats should be genetically perfect. Development of prion diseases supposedly takes months to cause such changes. Could it be the stasis stimulant leading to it?
Zombies.
March 20th, 2015, 3 a.m. I've just locked Spike Rockwell in the cage after tranquilizing him. It's not the cerebral palsy causing him limping. He had an accident in New Delhi 6 years ago, and a year after, he got a job as my assistant. He's been researching prion diseases for the past 8 years, and he was the one infecting our rats and my patient with prions, which my stasis stimulant affected and enforced an excessive mutation. He was bitten by Rat 23 a couple of days ago and came to me for help. As he's been infected with the same diseases, and now losing his mind, literally.
Yeah. So I found a poem and somebody had written, "You look nice today," with a smiley face. And the poem is "Oh Captain, My Captain" by Walt Whitman from 1865. It says, "Oh Captain, My Captain, our fearful trip is done. The ship was weathered every wreck, the prize we sought is won. The port is near, the bells I hear, the people all exulting, while follow eyes the steady keel, the vessel grim and darling. But oh heart, 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 oh the bleeding drops of red, where on the deck my captain lies, fallen cold and dead. Oh captain, my captain, rise up and hear the bells, rise up. For you the flag is flung, for you the bulge trills, for you bonnets and ribboned reefs, for you the shores a-crowding, for you they call the swaying mass, their eager faces turning. Here, Captain, dear father, this arm beneath your head, it is some dream that on the deck, you fallen cold and dead. My captain does not answer, his lips are pale and still. My father does not feel my arm, he has no pulse nor will. The ship is anchored, safe and sound, its voyage closed and done. From fearful trip, the victor ship comes with object won. Exalt, O shore, and ring, O bells, but I, with mournful tread, walk the deck. My captain lies, fallen cold and dead."
Thank you. Zombies. Come on, zombies.
Thank you. Thank you.
Naismith is in Massville. Her last trace was a credit card transaction registered in Massville. I think she was following Richard Reed. What was she doing in this high school?
Thank you. Zombies! Why? Okay. Okay, 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 okay.
Huh? Right.
Thank you. Ah! Ha 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 ha!